Hello everyone, this is Amrit Pal Singh. I'm here to present my first video on the topic Apache Pig. I thought of making one video or set of videos for this topic because this topic has been left unexplored. It's quite useful tool to work with, and it's kind of beneficial for those persons or for those who find the MapReduce difficult to program. Because to work with MapReduce, one has to have the knowledge of Java, and it's too complex to handle that such code, because it's we need to write very lengthy codes in the terms of mapper, reducer, combined, and all the stuff. So like this, and along with Hive, came to rescue, and these are the tools available for analysis, and these are nothing but kind of a abstraction over the MapReduce. So instead of writing the MapReduce straight away, we'll be writing the code in the Pig language, which we call it as Pig Latin, and it will be behind the scenes, it will be converted to the MapReduce jobs and will be submitted to the Hadoop cluster. So instead of writing the complex stuff, complex code, we'll be writing the very few set of lines to execute the same stuff. So Pig is quite a useful tool for us. So that's a reason which motivated me to make a set of videos for this particular topic. So you can see in the front of you, I've already opened up the official documentation page. Although for this video, the installation and configuration is out of the scope because I'll be sharing some separate video for the same. So I'm assuming that for this, we have already, you must be having already have the Hadoop and the Pig installed. In case if you're using Cloudera VM, it's perfectly fine because it's have inbuilt capability of Pig functionality as well. So I'm assuming that you have everything is in place, and we are ready with the practical implementation of this little demonstration of this practical. So I'll be using the Pig for doing some simple analysis, there are a lot of things available in the Pig to be discussed about. So it's a quite vast topic. We have a set of functions, we have a set of keywords available through which we can analyze some complex stuff as well. But it's a first video, so I'll be sharing my thoughts on how we can analyze some simple file using the Apache Pig. So for that purpose, I've already opened up one link you can see on the screen right now. This is a link which I'll be referring for my data set. You need to go to this link. I'll be providing this link in my description box, and you need to just download this file right under the downloads. So I'll be putting all the necessary steps for carrying out this practical in my description box, so don't worry. So this is the input data, and after downloading this particular data set, you'll be getting three files. I'll show you that one. I've already opened up in my downloads. This is the one. You'll be getting three files into this. One is ratings, one is books.csv, one is called user.csv. So for this practical, we'll be using this one, the center one, the books.csv. Okay, so this is my input file. Although the extension is .csv, so we can expect that this file will be the comma separated file, but this file have some issues, right? It's not in a proper structured file. So we need to do some kind of cleaning as well. So for this practical, we'll be having four steps. First step will be preparing the data according to our needs. Second, importing the data into Apache Pig. Third, running the Pig commands, and then analyzing the data. So we are being a four steps: preparing, importing, running, analyzing. So this is the four step process which we'll be doing in this practical. So let's start with this. First of all, let me show you that what we have in this file, right? I'm already have this in my home location. I've already moved this file to my home location. Let me show you with the head command. So what we have in this books.csv. So this is the file. You can see it's not a proper structured file. You can see because it's not a comma separated file. This will be in my first line of code in this first line we have in this data set. And so you can see that separator here, which this file is having, is a not comma, it's a semicolon. So we need to now first prepare this file according to our needs. We need to do some kind of cleaning. For this purpose, I'll be using the one of the common command that we use in the Linux, which is called sed. So first step is to prepare the data. So I guess you must be aware of this sed command. If you're a Linux user, you must be aware of this. Sed stand for stream editor, right? I guess you must be aware of, like this word, this command. SED actually stands for stream editor, and it can perform a lot of operations on the file, like searching, finding, replacing, or insertion or deletion as well, even though without opening the file, right? So this is a quite powerful tool, and we can do insertion, deletion, searching, substitution, and it can also support some kind of regular expressions as well. So what we'll be doing now, like we'll be just replacing some of the words, and we'll be like substituting some of the words, right? This is the like thing first we'll do. So first, I will show you the command for this. Let me first run the things, and I'll be discussing step by step. Because you can see in this command, in this particular data set which we have, you can see that there's a delimiter is semicolon, which I've already have stated that there are also some escaped HTML entities which we need to clean up, and we have a quotes around all the values which can be removed. So these some we need to do some kind of cleaning process. For this, I'm having this command is which is I'll show you now. This is this command. Okay, with this command, like which is a SED command, right, which is stand for stream editor, which I've already have discussed about. What we'll be doing, we'll be replacing all the ampersand and we'll instances with the AND operator. That's why the first line says we are replacing all the ampersand with this symbol AND. Then we have this is nothing but the name of the file. That's why it is written here, and it's a pipe sign. And we also removing the first header line, which we can see this one, the first header line. And then we'll be also changing all the semicolons to the triple dollar sign. And we are changing all the triple dollar sign to the semicolon. Okay. And last, we are removing all the quotes. Okay. So maybe you must be thinking that why we are doing this triple S and all the stuff, triple dollar sign, some of the field contents may contain some semicolons in the data set, right? So in this case, they'll be converted to triple dollar sign, but they will not match this triple dollar pattern, because this is also a pattern in the regular pattern matching, and it will not be converted back into the semicolons and mess up the import process. So that's why we are doing this in this way. So you can see now what we are doing. We are now appending everything to this particular file. So this new file will be created automatically, right, from this file. So now this is my input file and this is my output file, what we are expecting from this step. So let's press enter. Okay, so this command got executed. So we have this file available with us, which is bxcorrected.txt. So next point is, now we have done this one. Now we need to import data, because now we are dealing with the PIG, and you know that PIG having a two modes of operation, map reduce mode. So generally we use a map reduce mode. So we need to create some SDFS directories as well for this. So first step is done. We have cleaned up the process. We have cleaned up the files. So second step is to import data. For this, we need to create one directory in the SDFS. I guess you know the syntax as well. This is a regular SDFS command. So here we are creating the one input folder, which is an SDFS. So what we'll be doing, we'll be inputting the file, the bx, this one, into this directory. So we need to write Hadoop fs hyphen put command. I guess you know that we have a put command available, or we also have a copy from local. So we can use these any of the command. Then we need to give the path. So this is available on my home location. So let me, space input, right? Okay, done. So we have done the second process as well. Second step has been done. So first step was cleaning the data. We have done in the first step. Second step is to import data. We have imported the file. Now we can easily run my PIG. So how to run PIG? How to start with the PIG? Simply write PIG on the screen. This will by default will work in a MapReduce mode. So although there are multiple ways to run PIG, but we are going to run in MapReduce mode against the local mode, right? So MapReduce mode runs against the SDFS. That's why we need to import the data in this manner. Otherwise, if we are working with the local mode, then maybe this step is not important. Then it will be optional step. So press enter. Okay, you can see the grunt shell. I guess you know that this is the default shell we having, which is called grunt shell, right? So this indicates that PIG has been started. So what we have to do is, now we need to load data into the pig collection. So how to load data? For this, we need to make use of one keyword called load. Let me show you that keyword. This is the one. So what we'll be doing will be, this is any variable you can take. Okay, I'm just highlighting this command. This is the command we need to write. So let me discuss this step by step. First, we having a books, right? This is any variable you can take. Actually, in this case, there'll be no prefix. Like in a Scala, we used to have VAL or VAR, but in the case of this pig, like in a Python, we never prefix any variable with any type, right? So there's no prefix available. Then space, then equal to, then space. So load is my keyword, which is helping me to load the file, right? Then what we'll be doing, we need to now give the proper path, right? In this case, the path will be, because the path is under my input, so we need to change this to this, okay? Because my file is in this location, right? Home Amrit input bx books corrected.txt. Okay, till this point we're just like giving the absolute path where my file is located, and then we have a using pig storage. So I guess you must be aware of this thing. What is pig storage? So pig storage is a function that loads and stores data as a structured text file. It actually takes some delimiter, right? Because in my case, the delimiter is not the regular CSV. The delimiter we are using in this file is semicolon, so we need to pass the semicolon in this case. So it takes a delimiter using which each entity of the tuple is separated as a parameter. So it's nothing but some regular is a default load and store function we have. No worries, I'll be posting some videos in which all the basics will be covered, right? So for a while, just remember, this is nothing but a load and store function which is helping us in loading the file. Then AS stand for alias, right? And then we can decide that in which way we want that schema. This is the schema definition in this case. So till this point, AS stand for alias. So it defines how the fields in the file are mapped into the pig data types. So in this case, what we are doing, we are taking first a field or attribute as char array. In this way, we define in the pig, the first we need to give the column name or attribute name, then colon, then give the type. So char array is my type. Similarly, book title will be my second attribute. Just imagine like in RDBMS, we used to have our tables, right? We used to have a column. So this is the columns for us. And we are giving the types, data types, comma, book author. And then we have a year of publication and publisher. So we are having five columns in total along with their types. So we are having one, two, three, okay, four of char arrays, one is of integer. So press enter here. Okay, so you can see now it's been loaded. Okay, first check it out whether we have done it in right manner. So we are having one keyword called describe. Okay, we used to have a describe keyword in RDBMS as well to know the schema or structure of a table. So we can use describe books. You can see now it is in a proper shape. Whatever we have given, it's in a proper shape. Just see, same thing available here. Okay, so it means everything is fine till this point. So let's start with doing some little analysis on it. First of all, we need to find the books by year. Okay, so what we'll be doing, we'll be just performing the regular group by clause. In the case of pig, the group by has a different syntax if we compare with the SQL in the RDBMS. So what we'll be doing, we'll be just grouping the collection, whatever collection we are having, by the year of publication, right? Think this word collection as a table, we are referring to a table. This is my now table, this books, okay? Although we call it as collection in this terminology. How we can do it? So I've already have written this line, so let me show you. Okay, first of all, this is the thing I'll be using. This is again any variable you can take. Okay, this is not a keyword, so you can take any variable, then give space, then equal to, then space. This is the syntax of group by. Group is a keyword. Give the attribute name around which you need to apply the group by clause. By is again a keyword. Then how you want to group this books? You want to group this book by the year of publication. It means, let's suppose if books are in 2000, let's suppose I need to club all the books which are in the year 2000 in this way. This is the interpretation of this command, right? Okay, press enter now. It's done. Again, you can check whether everything is going well or not. We can describe and we can write group by year. Group by year. Okay, so if you are saying this word group, it means that it's been grouped already. It's a grouped thing. It means group by has been applied successfully. Actually, this is nothing but it's a lot like a Java map. The group by year collection contains all unique year values along with the list holding the full entry of the each book that belongs to that year, which I've already said that all the books of the particular year will be clubbed together, will be grouped together. Then we need to, what we can do now next analysis part we can do is that we need to now generate the book count by year. Already we have now applied the group by, the books got collected, books got aggregated. Now we need to find what's the number of books published in that year. So for this, I've already written the command, which is this, count by year. Yep. So in this case, first of all, we need to, yep, okay. So this is the command. So this is again another variable we are taking, count by year, for each. So this is my meat of the operation. The for each loops over the group by year collection and we generate values. Okay, so our output is defined using some values available to us within the for each. So if we first take group, which is an alias for grouping value, and say to place it in our new collection named year of publication. So in this case, AS again is my alias. So this is nothing but I'm just creating a new collection which is called year of publication. Now the next thing is you must be wondering that what is this $1 is all about. It's another way of defining the fields. $0 means the first column, $1 means second column. So the next value $1 is an alias for the list of book entries for that group, or you can think that this is my second column, second attribute, because we have an index starting from 0. Okay, so this is my $0, this is my $1. So I want to apply the count aggregate operation on this second field $1, and this I want to name as book count. So whatever, if you are presenting this result, if you publish this result, or if you want to print this answer, this output of this command on the screen, you will find the column names as year of publication and book count. So this is my aliases, that's why I'm using AS. Okay, so press enter. Okay, so far so good. So the last step is now coming up. I want to now see that what we have achieved till this point, because we have done a lot of things. We have loaded the data, then we have applied the group by, then we also applied the count operation on it. So I need to find that what's my result. For this, we have one command called dump. Dump is you can think like it's a select star from table name. So it's a dump command available. Dump space that variable name or which we have used, which is count by year. When you press enter, you will be finding that a lot of things will be going on behind the screen. As I've already told you, that pig is nothing but like an abstraction over the MapReduce complex code. So behind the scenes, these commands, whatever we have written on this grunt shell using pig Latin, will be converted or will be compiled to the MapReduce jobs, right? Press enter. Okay, you can see MapReduce is going on, like behind the scenes, right? This is a MapReduce, just see MapReduce framework is working behind the scenes. We got answer now. That this is the one that we had in this year, 1376. On this year, only one book got published. In this year, 98, we have this much of books got published. So this is the count of the day, count of the the books as per the year, right? As per the data set. So because we were expecting only two columns, so that's why we having two fields available, this one year and the count. I hope you must have understood from this particular video how we can make use of simple analysis in the pig. But in the subsequent videos, I'll be discussing the things in more detail, and I'll be discussing that how we can do advanced analysis and how we can make use of some other predefined or inbuilt functions, in which I'll be discussing the things in more detail. I hope you must have understood from this video some basics of pig Latin or pig. In case if you have any doubt, anything, maybe if I've said it something wrong, kindly comment on my video. I'll be happy to address that stuff. Thanks for watching. See you next video.